12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig. That's Blammer. He's been quiet right now.
And on this week's show.
On this week's show, we have got, first of all, Hannibal, The Truth from a Liar. Two-volume DVD set. His full 45-minute parlor-style show. Filmed live in front of a real audience.
And it's very similar, there's a reason for this, very similar to that Alien Concept double DVD sex. Mm. It's produced by Anthony Asimov, same guy.
It is. And basically what they've done is they've taken Hannibal and they've got him to do his full show, and then he's sat down in the studio afterwards, he's broken it down, and he's gone through every single routine, bit by bit by bit by bit.
And the show is on both discs, isn't it?
Yeah.
So even if you buy volume one or volume two, you'll have to look on the website to see what's on each disc, but basically there's like half the act
absolutely
on each disc, and there's some bonuses on it's actually volume
it's
two
and balls and
it's
stuff.
Got his cups and balls and a great interview as well, which is very insightful about storytelling and that kind of thing. How would you sum up Hannibal as a character?
He's intriguing. If I had to say one word, is intriguing. You know, like you see some performers.
He's a great storyteller.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Some performers, they just come out there and they're like, boom, 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 and you kind of get almost like bowled over by magic. This guy very much takes his time. He's very methodical.
Very disarming as
well. Very disarming. His storytelling is... He's got one of those voices where you just want to listen to him and you're interested in what he's saying. And he looks... You're not going to get this reference at all, but he looks very similar to Bray Wyatt, who's a professional wrestler in the WWE.
Right, okay.
He looks just like Bray Wyatt. I could see this guy being a wrestler. But he's very disarming. He's very... And you want to sit there. I was sitting there listening to him going, oh, I'm finding this really interesting. But he's also very skilled. I mean, he's very talented. Some of the stuff he was doing, there were moments when I thought, ooh, ouch. But generally, as a rule, he was very skillful.
Yeah.
And I think one of the best routines to actually illustrate this point is the very first routine, which was Silver Memories, which was the coin and cylinder and coin routine.
Yeah, and this is kind of like a story about him when he was younger and that kind of thing. And
he really made cylinder and coins his own.
And then the music comes on. Mm-hmm. And it's very much like an artistic sort of performance piece, isn't
it? And he was talking about his grandfather and so on and so forth. And it was a beautiful routine, very emotional. And what was great
Pretty
about...
emotional.
It was, I was very emotional.
All right, okay. All right, okay.
And what does it say there? Emotional connection.
Oh, emotional connection.
I'm not the only one that thinks it.
Absolutely.
Very, very emotional. But he took a routine, which I've studied. The cylinder and coins, I think, is considered one of the it's like the cups and balls for coin magicians.
Yeah.
It's the routine that you have to master in order to be considered.
I think it's the perfect illustration of why his style wouldn't suit me, though.
Or me.
Because it's a style that's very suited to a respectful performing environment.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where people are like, I've come to see a great magician, I'm just going to sit back and I'm going to enjoy it.
Yeah.
There are lots of places where you would be doing this and somebody would be sat at the table and you'd be, I'll just put this in there, and they'd be going...
Yeah,
like
absolutely,
this.
Completely.
And you can't have that.
No.
Sorry, Blummer. You can't have that.
Scared him to death now. Yeah, absolutely. His stuff would not work in your average UK corporate close-up.
No. It's very much a parlour environment, which is exactly what they're selling.
Absolutely.
And people are sitting back, ready to enjoy a show of storytelling, magic, performance pieces.
Yep.
And you need to bear that in mind. There are a couple of effects which would work in any environment. I particularly like the one he did with the guy cutting off a few cards.
Yes,
he
called that
call
the
it?
Strange Engine.
Yeah, and I'm sure it's something you may have seen before if you studied the gimmick and the methodology involved, is that fair to say?
Yep.
But actually, when you watch it, I said to you, there is no way on this earth that a layman would have any idea how that worked.
No.
And it's kind of like a deck that's been used throughout, it's been shuffled by a spectator, cuts them off.
Yep.
Then he said to somebody, pick a card, and then what's your age or something? It was like, what age would you like to go back to? 29, count down 29 cards. There was the card.
It was amazing.
Yeah, and this is all covered, you know, there's a little bit of, you know, other stuff going on, trick that can't be explained and
that kind
of stuff. But the actual core effect where the guy cuts off the cards and then he reveals those cards one at a time, which is a classic routine. The way he presents it, you're looking at it and you're like, that is a miracle.
I tell you the routine that stood out for me.
Go on.
And I think you could use it as a standalone piece and it would work in a outside of the parlour environment, was his Pringles act. Hannibal's entire prize-winning nine-phase powerhouse routine using a deck of cards and a Pringles chip can.
With no Pringles, with M&Ms in them.
I loved the finale with the card
Let's just go step by step. It's basically a card routine. The card keeps appearing under the Pringles can.
Yep.
Then the deck is under the Pringles can.
He's got a
very
nice...
similar to card and assault shaker. Michael Close, structured in a very similar way.
He's got a moment where the signed card keeps going from one pocket to another pocket to
another pocket, which
was very Gary Jones-esque. It was really nice. You know, this pocket.
And he's like, it's not like I've got a copy of the same card signed in this pot, and he keeps bringing out a signed card. It looks great, but at the end, the bit you were getting to, they tip out the Pringles. Amongst the Pringles is one card with a peg.
Yeah,
very very natural, very very logical as well.
Yeah, absolutely. For
then just to pick that up, take it off the peg, and it's their signed card.
Yeah.
Great.
I really like it. I wasn't too enamoured with the final routine, Golden Memories, which was the singing thing.
It's not that it's bad. It's that a lot of these routines are very personable to Hannibal himself. Mm. And it's almost like, not that you don't want to do them, you wouldn't want to do them. They're kind of like a part of him.
Well, it's
what makes it enjoyable to watch.
Yeah.
But it's what makes it a little bit of a negative for the DVD if you're looking for something for yourself.
Yeah.
Is that absolutely. Be fair to
no,
say?
No, that's fair to say. I wouldn't expect anybody here, don't expect to buy these DVDs, watch the explanations, immediately say, right, I'll put that in my act next week. It's not going to happen. You're going to have to do some serious work in order to adapt these routines to fit your personality, because they are so Hannibal-y. I think that's the best word to describe it.
They're Hannibal-y. But at the same time, you will learn a lot.
And I tell you what, I'd sit a layman down in my living room and say, hey, you like good magic. Watch this.
Watch a good show. Yeah,
I just put this show on for them, and I know they'd have a good time.
Yeah, they're good. Very artistic. Great show. Great material. I just don't know if you'd use any yourself. Still great to watch, though. I'll give it 80%.
Yeah, I'm going to give it 85%. Very enjoyable. Love his Cylinder and Coins. Will I do anything? Not too sure, but definitely worth studying. Well done, Hannibal.
Right, you ready to do this? Hand over your wedding ring, John.
Yep, come on, John.
No,
we want your ring.
That is my ring.
No, it's not. I want your wedding ring, John. I want an emotional connection with you. Give me your wedding ring.
That is...
I don't want this one. Give me your wedding ring. Tell him, Dave.
He won't do it.
Not going to do it.
No, he won't do it. You've got to do it with that one.
So pathetic.
Get it off the sticks. Right. This is Dreamlock.
By Alan Wong.
By Al Wong.
Al Wong. We have a...
Is it a dream?
Is it a dream?
Let's see.
Reality?
We're going to do it.
We have a padlock. It's
John's
a combination
already
padlock.
Had it done on him. He's not that impressed.
Four different digits.
Four different digits, four different possibilities.
Well, actually, 9,999 possibilities.
Well, no, more.
No, come on. Is that real? Is that a real statistic?
Of course there is. If it's a four-digit padlock, then the most that it can go up to is 9,999. So it's going to go from 0001 to 9,999. So you have 9,009. Okay, you've got 10,000.
Thank you.
10,000.
Is that right? I'm sure there's probably more. Put it on Facebook, the real answer.
The real answer.
How many combinations?
We'll send you a free DVD.
I know the real answer. The real answer. I'm just going to mix these
and tell us why it's the right answer. What are you doing now?
I'm mixing all these numbers so you don't know which one unlocks.
Oh, right, okay.
So we've got it all.
So it's a combination padlock?
Combination padlock.
Just pop back from B&Q.
Yep, go
from B&Q. Matthew.
Yep.
It's
sturdy-ish. Yes, it's sturdy. Right. It won't open now, because obviously it's not set to the correct padlock.
Don't hold it too long.
You hold it as long as you want to, John. Right, hold
it's
on to
exactly
the...
It's not exactly true,
the,
is it? Where just, would you
just,
like me
just,
to hold
just
it?
Just there with both hands, you know. So
like that.
Yeah, that's great. So here's the thing, Dave. Basically, we've got a situation here. Is when we mix these up, it's the chances of actually it coming off is just unlikely, because you know, check it. It's unlikely.
It's locked.
Of course, there's 10,000 combinations.
10,000.
10,000. So we're gonna try something here. What I want you to do is there's four digits. We'll go with the first digit first. Think of a number between 0 and 9. What you got?
Between 0 and 9. 3?
Okay. You could have gone for one. I'm sorry. You could have gone for zero and nine.
No,
well,
I could have done. Yeah, you could have done.
I should have said that. John, give me a number between zero and nine. You could have zero and nine as well. Don't let me limit you.
Eight.
Okay. Yeah. Eight. You go for it, Dave. What number would you like now?
I'll go two.
Hey.
This can't
don't
be.
Twiddle my knob. Right, there we go. And which one would you like?
Four. No, it's not
going to
open, is it?
It can't be. Out of all those combinations. 10,000
combinations.
Is that the line? There, that's it.
Well, have a look. See if
it can't be. It really can't. No, not out of all those combinations. Hang on. Oh, my God.
Isn't it amazing?
Hey. Ooh.
I know. It's just.
How much is that, John?
100 odd quid.
There you go. There's the end of the review right there. That's
100 quid for a padlock that doesn't work properly. It's
what should be called Nightmare Lock.
The concept behind it is, I mean, the whole idea is good. I like the idea of having the effect.
I think there's been other methods out that are better than this, hasn't there?
Yeah, the method's a little bit dodgy. I did it on on John when I first opened it, and it didn't work because John was being an arse.
No, he wasn't being an arse.
Spectator.
You said check it, whittle it around, check all these, and he did, and it opened straight away.
Yeah, and unfortunately,
right. Be honest, Craig. Be honest. What is the chances of that happening between 0 and 10? What is the chance of that happening with a punter in the real world?
Ten being every time.
What are the chances of that if you say check this out?
9.5.
I think probably 9 exactly, yeah. Yeah, it's probably 9.
Yeah, it's quite high. You have to have some serious audience management. Because
they can't. Like, we don't want to reveal the secret because it's quite a cleverly gimmicked padlock. It's just not gimmicked enough.
No.
For the real world.
Once the ring is on the padlock.
You can't give them this. You can't give them it and say, you know, just turn it to any combination. Does it open?
No, you can't.
Which I think, for the routine to be strong and to have the impossibility actually connect with people, and people go, no, it doesn't work. It does not work. Oh, my God, we've just thought of a random number. Now it did work. For that to be any kind of effect, you've got to convince them, first of all, that a random number will not open it. And you can't convince them that a random number will not open it.
Yeah.
You can't convince them of that.
Because you can't let them twiddle the knobs themselves. You have to do the twiddling.
Well, I think if how it works was somewhere different, does that make sense? Am I okay saying that?
Yeah.
It wouldn't be as it would be actually more convincing.
Yeah. But as it is, it's and it's 100 quid. I mean, if it was like a fiver or something, you'd think, you know, I'll play around with it and see if I can make it work. But it's 100 quid. It's 100+ quid.
Because the first thing is, if you say to a spectator, you know, just do some random numbers, is that going to open? They just, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. It's.
And that's what a punter will do. They're not going to go, you know, they're just going to go spin and try it.
I'm sure.
And it will open.
You're right. I'm sure there's been better versions of this out there.
There has been better versions.
This is just like, it's when you read the instructions, you think, all right, I can see that working. That'll work. And then the first time you actually try it on someone, you go, okay, well, there's massive fatal flaw here then.
The only positive thing, if you're going to say a positive thing, is if you've got a routine where you are entirely comfortable with demonstrating the lock turning yourself and then getting them to just pull it.
Yeah.
And then turning it a bit more and getting them to just pull it and then put the number in, their chosen number, and they pull it and it opens, you're okay with this.
I'm sure.
But if you want it to be more hands-on, and I think for 100 quid,
I'm sure,
it should be great, this, for 100 quid.
The world's greatest mentalists, the Richard Osterlins of the world, the Max Mavens of the world, they could probably take this and make it a performance piece. But, you know, why compromise? You know, you can do much better stuff than this. If you're going to be a mentalist, you can do much better stuff than this that's more fooling and will get a better reaction than this.
It's very expensive for what it is. It's a nice quality padlock, but it doesn't work as well as I would need it to make it a strong routine. And for that, and especially at that price, I'm only giving this 5%.
Yeah, I Because it's a bit harsh, but I completely agree with you. I mean, it's so expensive and it ain't going to work hardly at all. I'd give it...
I think people, if they haven't seen this, might be in danger of seeing the price and thinking, I bet that's really clever, I bet it's ingenious. And the secret's just not good enough. Mm. And it's not all about the secret. I'm surprised I'm even saying that. But actually, you need a secret that you can rely on if you're going to deliver a great, convincing routine.
Absolutely.
Did you give it a percentage?
No, I'll go along with you, 5%. I think you've got it nailed. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It's time for the Master Magician to relieve us from the dream lock syndrome. Luis de Matos.
Mr. de Matos. The man, the myth, the legend.
The egg bag. He always looks like a magician.
He always does.
You never see him at Blackpool, do you? In like, you know, khaki shorts and a t-shirt.
No.
He never gets old. He never gets stuck in...
He's never out of the zone, is he? No, he's never out of the Luis zone.
This is a guy that owns his own production studio.
Yeah.
I mean, come
TV
on. TV studio in his house. He's got his own TV studio. He wakes up, he goes out his front door, and he's got a TV studio.
Does he ever have time off, though? I don't know. But maybe he's not happy deep down having that big studio. Maybe he needs to give it to me.
Yeah,
so he can have some time off.
I think
that would be good.
Definitely.
So we're going to summarise this.
Luis, we know you watch the show. Just let me know if you would like to give all of your stuff to Dave. Yeah. I'm sure he'd be
all
happy
that equipment,
that
lovely green screen studio. We don't need that, do we? The egg bag. This is basically a performance piece that's been featured in Luis's live show. He explains on the DVD that he always performed it in his live show for a kid. You can see how this works. And the footage is actually live performance footage. It's Portuguese with English subtitles. And it's from a TV show that he actually filmed at his TV studios.
Yeah.
With him with celebrities in the audience. But the nice thing is you get to see a full performance. You get to see it very nicely shot. You get to see him interacting with the spectator. And you get to see the egg bag presented beautifully, like a master magician.
I'll tell you something right now. I have studied the egg bag. I have looked at Dan Tong. I've looked at Curtis Cam, who produces a frying pan.
Yeah.
I've looked at Jeff Hobson.
Yeah, yeah.
Patrick Page.
Yeah.
I've looked at some of the greatest egg bag performers in the world. And this is the first product that I've actually looked at and watched a performance of, including Hobson.
It's beautiful.
That's made me want to go, I want to put that in my act.
It's just the way he gets into it. I've never seen that before. He explains on the DVD that he's very influenced by Johnny Thompson. Johnny Thompson influenced him to really get into the egg bag. But just that whole concept of starting with your pocket, and it's a magician's pocket. Yeah. It's quite interesting. We talk about it all the time on the Wizard Product Review. What's the hook?
Yeah.
That's always something that's quite important to me and Craig. Why does he actually engage spectators rather than just I'm doing this for me, pick a card or whatever? But this, you know, have you seen a magician's pocket? And then it's almost a surprise when it kind of comes out.
Yeah, and it actually is a little,
because they believe it's the real pocket, and it's just a nice moment. And the way he presents it, there's so many beautiful moments.
He's got so many personal touches in it.
Just the first bit where it's kind of like a paper balls over the head style.
Yeah, there's an
moment.
Entire phase that he's just basically took paper balls over the head and put it into the egg.
Kind of like openly palming the egg so the audience can see it, but it still looks a miracle to the spectator that's on stage. Mm-hmm. The spectator management is beautifully executed.
Or executed.
He's got some great bits that you know are going to work, where you've got a kid on stage and you're reaching around their head and they're holding the wrists and you're producing the egg. And no matter how many times you see the egg bag, when you see a great magician doing it, and I do mean a great magician, you're watching it being folded up. And you're just thinking,
where the bloody hell is
that? How the hell can that be in there? And we forget this sometimes.
We do, yeah. I sometimes forget how skillful Luis de Matos is.
Yeah.
Because you see him making cars appear and sawing women in half and doing the most amazing illusions you've ever seen. And you forget that the guy is a very talented sleight of hand worker.
Do you know why he's so good? I'll tell you why he's so good.
Go on.
Right, I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why some of the greatest magicians in the world are so good. I'll tell you why. It's because they're living it. It's in their eyes. They're actually living each moment.
Yeah.
And they are experiencing that.
Experiencing.
You watch a great performer, and every single time they reach into the bag, they're living it in their eyes.
They believe that it's real magic.
They're believing it. You look at any great, and they believe it. They're living that moment. Mm. And it's a perfect demonstration of that all the way through this routine. And every single moment of magic, it's impossible. Absolutely impossible. And the moment it comes back, it's incredible. It might not be a car, but that egg is just as incredible to him at that moment when it appears. And because he's living it so well as a performer, it just connects with everybody out there. And they experience the magic with you. It's fantastic.
I completely agree with you.
At the end of the day, you could say it's just an egg bag routine with a great finale. But the teaching on there, the way it's explained, if you want to learn an egg bag routine from a master magician, you need to look nowhere else.
This is the
product to get. Forget about everything else. This is the one to get. We're not just learning somebody's comedy routine here. We're learning about everything to do with the egg bag.
Yeah.
Now, great finale. Are you going to do it?
You know what? I'll tell you right now. Probably not. the finale, you don't have to do this if you don't want to. The routine will stand up fine without it. And I've asked myself this question since we watched the DVD. Would I do the finale? Because this guy, obviously, Lewis, obviously does it a lot. He goes to the trouble of taking a portable incubator to his shows loaded up with one-day-old chicks.
Because he produces a day-old chick at the end, which does look incredible.
Yeah.
But he gives it away to the kid to take back to... Can you imagine doing that in the UK?
Yeah.
Can you imagine sending the kid back to their seats...
With a one-day-old chick.
Their dad, you know. Like... What the hell am I supposed to do with that? You know, and and he's thinking, now will it actually block the toilet? I'm not sure.
couldn't do it in the UK, but you could make a chick appear. And I'll tell you,
you could
it's
do it for
a
TV.
Perfect example of why is Lewis considered one of the, if not the top illusionist in the world and one of the greatest magicians of all time? It's because he, as a performer, is prepared to go above and beyond the call of duty. Anybody else might go out and do an egg bag routine and stop right there. However, this is a guy who said, no, that's not enough for me. I want to go to the next level. And he goes to ridiculous lengths to get this finale, which is just ridiculous.
Can you imagine have like a six-year-old girl out on stage, her face when that chick appears?
Yeah, can you imagine? And I tell you what, Rao, there's going to be people and they are going to remember him not for the cars appearing.
Oh, I know.
They're going to remember him for that moment where he made that chick appear.
Yeah,
and gave it away.
Yeah,
that moment, and
it's not going to suit us. Yeah. We're not going
to
do it.
But you have to look at yourself as a performer, and you have to say to yourself, "Are you happy with the level that you are at?" And if you're not happy with the level you're at, maybe you're not doing everything that you need to do to get to that level, and maybe the stuff that Lewis is doing, which many of us, including myself, look at and go, "That I said to you,
Lewis.
That's Lewis. Stupid." Sorry, Lewis.
Luis.
Looked at it. I said to you, that's stupid. Yeah. You know, there's going to be many people that have the same attitude as me, but maybe that's why I'm not driving around in a Ferrari and I have
own
a
your
TV
own
production
TV
company. Studio,
yes.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? It's like, how far are you going to go to be...
It's all about the next level. As far as I'm concerned, he's taken the egg bag as a product to the next level.
Mm.
It's a nice egg bag.
I'm having it.
If you want to make your own, he even talks about that, talks about the material, where to buy it, what sort of material it needs to be if you want to produce your own egg bag. It comes with one, a basic one for you to get on with and
Malini
start
style.
With it. It's a Malini style egg bag. Every single part of the routine, every single aspect of it that makes it absolutely incredible that even myself and Craig are watching the DVD and we're going, hang on, where is it now?
Yeah.
Where is it now?
Yeah.
It's back.
Yeah.
And also, I must just tip the hat for that bit on the edge as well. I'd never seen that before.
Oh, no, where he's
balanced
it
on the edge. And
then he goes...
Look, we've said too much.
It's great.
98%.
Yeah.
If you want to learn the egg bag, and it just so happens that you've got a budget for this month, 100%.
Yeah.
Because this is the one.
And if you haven't considered learning the egg bag. I know that there's people out there that go, oh, I'm not going to learn the egg bag. It's rubbish. Sorry. Just watch him perform this and then say that, because this can work table hopping. It can work walk around. It can work in a parlor show. It can work cabaret. It can work on an illusion show. Well, it can work for the biggest or kids shows, everything.
I'm doing a show at the moment, and Faye Presto is in the show. And there's a moment in the show where she just sits on the stage. And it's at the start of the second half, and she sits on the stage at the front, and she does a rope routine, doesn't she, John?
Yeah.
In a single spotlight. I think it's the best moment in the whole show, because it's so simple. It's just great theatre. I think it's the best moment in this whole show we're doing. And it's just because it's so stripped down, and it's so beautiful. The egg bag is so much like that.
Yeah.
If you want a moment like that in your show, I'll tell you what. Give this egg bag a go. Give it a go with a kid from the audience. It could be the standout piece of magic in your show.
Absolutely, 100%. I think it's brilliant.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Some great products once again for some great performers. Padlock aside, have you left me with this one?
Yeah,
the Hannibal.
You can have Hannibal.
No worries.
And we'll the Dreamlock.
And the Dreamlock. I get that as a special bonus. Thank you very much. I can go home and try to unlock it.
There you go.
That won't take long. that's it. We'll see you next week. Follow us in all the usual places, facebook.com/worldmagicshop.
You can follow both of us on Twitter. You can follow us on the Magic Cafe.
Office
of Advisement. And
YouTube, please hit the button in the corner and subscribe. It's that corner now.
Is it that corner?
It's like a little red thing.
And jump into our circle on Google Plus. Do you have Google Plus for World Magic Shop?
Yeah. Google Plus.
Yeah, get us on Google Plus.
Yeah, nice. You're always sticking stuff on there, aren't you?
Yeah, all the time.
All right, thanks very much for joining us. We'll see you next week on the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Ray.
See you next week.